Today, once again, I'm coming to you from Country Classic Cars here in Staunton, Illinois. And today I've got something pretty unique for you. This is actually a 1953 International R120 Panel Truck. And this one is particularly interesting because it was owned by a company called Southern Maid Donuts. It was a company that was founded in 1937 in Louisiana. But it's also of note because it was considered Elvis Presley's favorite donut. He also did a commercial for them back in 1954 that he actually produced and sang in. And I believe that was the only commercial that he ever produced and sang in for a company. So he must have really liked the donuts. But also, it's just a very nice example of a panel truck. I mean, this thing is in beautiful condition, so I thought we'd check it out here. Obviously, they had it all painted up for promotional purposes. So you got this nice checkerboard pattern going down the side here and all their logos. And you can tell that once they restored this truck, they definitely kept it inside because it's been really well preserved. Just in beautiful shape. It has the black painted bumpers front and back. I like that it has the swing out style doors. Pretty cool. Take a peek inside here. The floor of the back here is very similar to a pickup truck from the same time period. So it's got the oak wood planks with the strips in between. Obviously everything's very utilitarian back here, just painted metal. But it's in excellent condition. Very nice. They have a few little things printed out so you can kind of check that out and learn about the company. It's probably a little dark, but I mean, this thing's just in beautiful shape. It's got the correct international hubcaps on there. Nice running boards. And this is the information about Elvis's involvement with the company. You can pause and read that. But I mean, that is a cool little piece of history to go along with the truck for sure. And this being 1953, this is from that time period when he would have done the commercial, so that's pretty neat. Got that nice international badge right there in the center of the grill. And the hood has dual releases there. This one, I tried to open it and it felt kind of stiff, so I don't want to break anything, so I'm not going to touch it. It's just powered by the original International six-cylinder, backed by a three-speed manual. So nothing too exciting going on under there anyway, but it is all factory original. And I'm sure if you want to see it, you can check out the website and they'll have a picture of the engine for you. You can see it's got a nice big visor over the windshield. Cowl vent right there in the center. It does have a spotlight, and that is a true working spotlight, not a dummy. Nice mirror over here. And the interior is in excellent shape as well. New door panels, nicely upholstered seat. It's a 50-50 split back bench seat. And then the dashboard, steering wheel, that all looks factory original. 80 mile per hour speedometer, and then you have a multi-gauge to the left. It is a three on the tree, you know, three speed on the column there. New visors. I mean, it's just like a new one. Has a simple rubber floor in it. It's always nice in a work vehicle, so you can just rinse it out. You got your fuel filler over here on the driver's side. But I mean, this thing has no rust. I guess it had to be kept inside all the time. Just beautiful. But I thought it was a pretty unique find, you know? Even without the tie-in to Elvis, it's still a very cool truck, even on its own. Let's go ahead and check out the specs on it. Once again, it's a 1953 International R120. And redone interior, oak cargo floor. Runs and drives, 22,950. But anyway, guys, hopefully you found that as interesting as I did. As always, I do appreciate you watching and commenting, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.